Okay, let's give you guys some practice. So loadupdecimals.com, I will put in the link in the description below. Draw a circle of radius A, and an angle of pi over 6. So somehow, within decimals, come up with the parametric equations to simulate a particle oscillating back and forth like this, along this line. So so let me just illustrate it to you. So somehow, simulate a particle oscillating back and forth along that line within the circle. Okay, so press pause and have a go. Okay, so so let's try and do this from scratch. So first, first draw our circle. Hang on. First draw our circle, so that will be a cos t, comma a sine t, close it off, add our slider. A represents the radius of our circle, so let's change it from 0 to, I don't know, let's say 10, and then t ranges from 0 to let's say 2pi, and then this is our circle. We can change the radius. So A, as we slide A, it changes the radius. Now let's draw our line. So looking at our line, any straight line would be of the form y equals mx plus c. So you can see that the intercept here is 0. So we can put 0 into the c. So so that will then disappear. So now it's just a matter of working out the gradient. What is a gradient? Well, here we've got a circle of radius A. So the height here will be A sine pi over 6. And the across here would be A cos pi over 6. So the gradient will always be the height divided by the across. So it will always be the height divided by the across. So the gradient would be a sine pi over 6 over cos pi over 6, which is also known as tan pi over 6. So this is our gradient. So we can now put this into here. So we can draw our straight line now. It will be y equals tan pi divided by 6, close it off, and stick an x in there. Because at the moment, as it stands, this is just a gradient. It is just a gradient. We need to stick our x in there. So stick an x in there. So that would be our straight line. So now we need to add our particle. So particle would be, use a new variable, let's call it b, comma, and then b tan bracket pi divided by 6, close it off. So add our b. So let's get it b to vary from 0 to, I don't know, let's say 10 pi, and then now this is our particle. But the problem is it doesn't oscillate. So hang on. So as you slide back and forth, it doesn't really oscillate. When you press play, it just zooms off. Okay, it doesn't really oscillate. So now we need to get it to oscillate back and forth. So looking at this, this describes our line. So hang on. So currently our line is given by this. By b comma b tan pi over 6. So currently that's our line. So for given b, let's say b is here, the across is b, and then if you put it into here, it will jump to the line. It will jump to here. Suppose b is here. If you put b, this tells you the across, and then this tells you the height. So when b is here, it will jump to the line. So let's say when b is, I don't know, negative 3, when b is negative 3, put the negative 3 into here, and it will jump to the line accordingly. The point is that this thing here will always jump to the line. So suppose b is here, it will jump to the line. Suppose b is here, it will jump to the line. So now to simulate something that oscillates back and forth. Well, any time you have something that oscillates back and forth, like a pendulum oscillating back and forth, or a body with two springs, it will oscillate back and forth. Think anything that any time you have something that oscillates back and forth, think about the sine graph. So think about the sine graph. But the thing is, currently, this b here is like is in the x direction. It would jump to the line. Suppose it's here. It would jump to the line. Suppose b is here. It would jump to the line. This b is in the x direction. So if we can somehow simulate it, rather than simulating the particle oscillating back and forth like this, we are just going to look at, hang on, straight here, and then from here straight here. So we are just going to get b. Well, we need to create a new variable, c. We need to get c to oscillate back and forth like this. Well, we'll oscillate back and forth like this, not like this. Not like this, but like this. Okay, so if we need c to oscillate back and forth. So we need, well, to get it to oscillate back and forth, we're going to use a sine graph. So if this has a radius of a, then the across here would be a cos pi over 6. You see, if we can make this sine graph to have a maximum magnitude of a cos pi over 6, so this thing here, so by the time it gets to here, it would be right here. So which will, well, when you put it into here, it will automatically jump to the line. And then this bit here is when the particle is over here. Let's say this is negative cos pi over 6. So this is negative. This is negative a cos pi over 6. So now by using a sine graph, we can get it to oscillate back and forth like this. We can get it to oscillate back and forth like this. So this is a sine graph. So it would be sine b, and then the magnitude. Remember, if we just stick this in here, it will give us a maximum magnitude of this. So it would be this a cos pi over 6. So, and then this, we can set this to be c, a new variable. So we would need to change this to c, and then this to c tan pi over 6. I hope you understand this. Let me just illustrate in Desmos. So what we've done here is we've created a machine where we input the slider b into here, and then it will spit out a new variable, c. But the good thing about c is that it oscillates back and forth like this. And it is a c that we're going to make use of, not b. Because b just ranges from 0 to whatever, and it just moves in one direction. It will just move in this direction. But then by us creating a function that gives us a c will oscillate back and forth like this. And don't forget, c represents the x coordinate. It just represents this x coordinate moving back and forth. Only when you put the x coordinate into the line, then it will jump to the line. So let's punch this equation in first. So let's set c. So c equals a cos pi pi divided by, oops, hang on, bracket pi divided by 6 close it off. And then this thing here, a cos pi over 6, is just this bit here. It's just the magnitude. It's just the magnitude here. Now we need to punch in sine b. So, sine b. So now we've got our c. The good thing about, so what c is doing is it's just oscillating back and forth like this, because because we made use of this sine graph. It just oscillates back and forth. Okay, so now we've got our c. So now we need to modify our line. So wait there. So going back to our particle, rather than using b, we are going to use c. So c, and then bear with me, and then c, and then press play on the b. So let's slow it down. So you can see it oscillates back and forth. So all it's doing is that c is just moving back and forth like this. But then it is this bit here that jumps, that causes the particle to jump to the line. So what c is doing is c is just moving back and forth like this. Well, anyway, I will also leave the link to this graph, so you can just load up this graph and play about with this. Okay.